Test coverage is one way to understand how much of our code is under control. The better coverage we have, the more confident we are that new changes to the code base won't break existing functionality. Hi, my name is Juani Bryson, and in this video, we're going to take a look at Go's inbuilt test coverage tools. We'll start by writing a couple of functions to cover. Then we're going to write a test and look at the coverage tools. And finally, we'll write a couple more tests just to get full coverage. So we're going to start with Go mod init, and I'm going to call this project tutorial/ddot, and I'm going to create a file called ddot.go, and we'll give it the package name ddot. And the first function that we're going to test is going to be called keys, which takes a map with keys of type string and empty structs as the values, and it's going to return a list of type string. So inside here, we're going to start with keys, which is going to be our string list. And then for each key in the range of our map, we are going to get our keys list and append to it the key of the map. Finally, we're going to return keys, and that's our first function. So the next function I want to write is called ddup, and this is going to take an input of a string list, and it's going to return a deduplicated string list. So effectively, if the same value shows up more than once in our input string list, it should be removed from our output string list. So to do this, we're going to create a map with keys of type string and empty structs as the values. And then for each value in the range of our input list, we're going to set the map's key to that value. So what this is going to do is that whenever that value shows up more than once in our input list, it's going to basically override that same entry in the map, effectively doing the deduplication for us. Finally, I'm going to return the keys of that map so that the map gets converted back into a string list. Now let's make a test for this ddup function. So I'm going to create a file called ddup_test.go. And in here, we'll give it the package name ddup, and I'll define a test called test ddup empty. Because I think the simplest test that we can do for ddup is to just pass in an empty list and expect an empty list back out. So I'll go result is equal to ddup and pass in an empty string list. And then I'm going to say if the length of result does not equal 0, then we're going to call t.fail. So if we run our test, then it passes, but we don't actually know how much of the ddup function we've actually covered. So let's try something else. Let's try a go test with the cover flag. And this tells us that 75% of the statements in our ddup package are covered, which is pretty good, but it doesn't tell us exactly which lines or which functions are being covered. So let's try a slightly different strategy. There's an option called cover profile, which will create a coverage file for us. I'll call this cover.out. And we can take a look at this, but it's kind of made to be machine readable. We can sort of read it because these parts here are the line numbers and these are kind of the columns in those lines. The zero here means that that line's not covered, but it's really not the kind of thing that we want to be looking at most of the time. Let's try something else. There's a Go tool called cover, and here we can specify a few different flags. One of them is func, and it will take this coverage file and tell us some more interesting information. The function keys is 75% covered, and the function ddup is 75% covered, but I'd like to know exactly which lines I need to write tests for. So let's try another one. Go tool cover html is equal to cov.out. And now I'm starting to get some more useful information. So what we're seeing in here is that our test is covering the lines in green, but it's not getting into these for loops. And that's basically because we're putting empty lists into these functions. Now, to be honest, when I'm coding in Go, I don't use any of these cover tools because VS Code has a really nice coverage tool built into the Go extension. So when I run these package tests here, it actually just highlights in the code which lines are and aren't covered. So now that we know what lines in our package aren't being covered, I want to make sure that we're covering all of the lines. So I'm going to copy and paste this test, change the name to ddup mini entries, and in here I'm going to add a few entries into our string list. So I'll go A, B, C, and D, and E. And I'm going to make sure that the length of the result is now 5. Save this, and if we go test cover down here, we've now testing 100% of our statements. So that's pretty good. One other thing I want to show you is that we can use something called cover mode in our test arguments. And if we set this to count and then call our cover profile with cov.out as the file, then when we use our go tool for cover with the HTML output, like so, we actually get a heat map of which lines are being covered. So you might notice that these lines in here are a little bit brighter, and that's because we're looping over them, especially in that test where we have 5 items in that list. Coverage gives us another metric to improve our confidence in test automation. Not only is it important to have 100% of our tests passing, but it's also a good endeavor to get as much of our code covered as well. I've been Huani Bryson, happy testing, and I'll see you later.